All right, well, we're back here getting ready to start the race. I guess 50 minutes. One pit stop, fuel and tires. Again, I just, you know, I qualified okay, but I mean, I could have done, definitely could have done better. I messed about.
Stay double five.
Probably a good tenth of a second at least. So I could have moved up in the top two rows, but I just couldn't put it together. A little too aggressive. You know, and you end up being too aggressive and it messes you up. So starting six, but of course, you got Sylvain next to me. He's very aggressive, so it kind of worries me. Hellstrom in front of me. Marys is up there. Larson's on pole. Saunders is up there in second. I mean, all fast. Chris Moses is right there. You see him in the mirror behind me. Well, kitty corner behind me. So we'll see what we can do.
Green light. Show them where to go.
Oh, Chris Bourne's behind me too, I think.
Car on the left. Clear on the left. Yellow flag in sector one.
Big jam up here. Sylvain is not going to be easy to get around. He fights big time. I think I got a good race package, but we'll see. McLarens are extremely strong here. Hopefully the tire pressures are close. Back on me again. Tight race.
Gaining on the car head in sector 2. Well done, mate. Your fastest lap so far.
Dang it. A little too deep. Dang it! better. Too deep. Not a good lap here. Good. Tell you, just hit it wrong and it screws you up. So I gotta be running. I need to be running high 28s.
The car is exiting the pits. Watch out.
Keep up with these guys. Ulster made a mistake that time. Good night.
You're gaining on the car, heading south. Slow car ahead.
That's the thing here, live traffic is going to be really difficult.
Van staying right there with me.
Two. It stops in about 5 minutes, 10 minutes. As you see, I gave Jim a break. My crew chief gave him time off. I'm getting an echo a little bit, and I'm trying to, I can't figure out why. If anybody's got any ideas, it's fine on my, you know, fine when I'm driving, but on the recording, I'm getting like an echo or something. I can't figure out what the heck it is. I've tried a couple different things. I've tried, taking it back out and reloading it back in, and just, you know, crew chief and everything else, and I still can't. It still does it a little bit, I think. So I don't know what's going on. Kind of miss him. I kind of like crew chief. Like hearing what other people are doing and things like that. But for some reason, just doesn't want to. I know it's probably irritating listening to the thing echo a little bit. So, if anybody got any ideas, let me know. not doing as good as I was hoping. I mean, time-wise. So, I was hoping it would keep around low 29s. It is hotter, though. I mean, it's like mid-20s. Track's like 30-something. So, it is a little warm. Chris got around Sylvain. Ten seconds behind me. That hurt my lap. Tires don't seem too bad. I think we had 39, so we lost 3 so far. holding its own. Definitely slower, but...
Yellow flag in sector 2.
Pit next time. Or this time, I should say. Should be fine as far as everything. I mean, I haven't... Everything should be good. Should have plenty of fuel. Tires should be good. Oh, I had 1.6 seconds of damage. I didn't see that, but oh well. I'll just fix it. Probably could have gone up maybe one on the tires, but it's all right. Just let it go.
Mandatory stop is not clear. Come on, go, go, go.
Mary's is right in front of me. Brad. Way now.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Go BMW! way again. Keep pushing. Go, go, go.
gaining on the car ahead in Sector 2. Well away, personal fastest lap.
Better see if I can do something a little better here.
Warning for exceeding track limits.
Dang it. Less than 10 minutes.
Slow car ahead. Yellow flag, be careful. Car on the right. Clear on the right.
Closing a little bit.
Hello, mate. This is me, your Russell Fest. Yellow flag, be careful there. There's a slow car ahead.
Traffic coming up, that's gonna be critical.
Yellow flag in Sector 2. Thank you.
barely hit it.
Final warning.
Dang it.
Exceeding track limits.
I'm gonna have to be careful. Good.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Going back away again.
The window is now closed.
Lap.
Falling behind to the car in front in sector 2.
Track limits? What track limits? Wow. Hey. I know I hit the grass. I think I've caught somebody in this corner like 3 times already.
Car on the right.
Just bad luck.
Car on the right.
And he's pulled right back away. It's a killer because it kills your down the straightaway. You. I mess it up.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
Brad's run a great race. I mean, just doing what he's got to do. So has Johan Larsson. He's up. You can see him up there. First podium. I'll take it, as I needed that third race of the year, and really needed a podium to try to make up some time, make up some points. So I don't know what happened to Saunders. So something happened to him. He must have quit. I don't know where he's at. Let me see. Well, where'd he go? I must be missing him somewhere. I don't even see him in here. So he must have quit. So at the end here, it'll show you know, what the standings are once everybody finishes. Coming up close. Chris finished fourth, 14 seconds behind me. Then Chris Bourne behind that in fifth. Sylvain finished sixth, looks like. So, tough race. A lot of traffic. So, it's definitely tough. Like I said, the hard part with all this traffic and stuff like that, you know, trying to make clean passes. Yeah, 32nd. So he didn't, he quit. Something must have happened. Save the replay. But anyway, really happy with the result, like I said. And let me go over some data and check some stuff, and we will come back here and definitely go over the setup. All right, well, I looked at the data and just went over some stuff, some things I didn't like, and I explained a little bit. I changed the springs at the last second, just because it just felt a little bit more compliant, a little bit better as far as the grip, and also, you know, with the track a little hotter than what I run at the temperatures at, I think it's all around better. It works both, but the problem was I ran out of time and I didn't really optimize the bump stop range and rate. So that's why I went back and did some more work on that. And it takes the second chicane down there to the bottom of the hill now a lot better. So you can be even way more aggressive in there without worrying about the thing tank slapping. Yeah, so again, I think it just an improvement in drivability and probably a little bit in performance, but I'm really happy with it. So let's go over the setup. I got 25 fore left front, 25 left rear, 26.2 right front, 25.7 right rear. The toe is a negative 0.15 in the front with the camber at negative 3.6 on the left front, negative 3.4 on the right front, and the caster at 12. The toe on the rear is a positive 0.05 with the camber at negative 3 on the left rear, negative 2.8 on the right rear. You can go to max out the toe here. I really didn't see any advantage to it, but maybe it's just the feel of the car. It has a little bit more turn in when you do that, so you can do that if you would like. Other than that, I really didn't see anything else that I could see. I ran more negative camber. Didn't see really any difference, to be honest, in performance, but I like the feel of this way better because you need the car to react so fast through these chicanes, be very precise and the curvings and stuff like that. So again, I really like this because with the negative camber taking some of that out, it just, to me, the car reacts quicker. Other than that, that's about it. Electronics, I got 4, 2, and 1. Of course, now I was running 3 a lot also. So just keep that in mind. I guess you could put 3, 2, and 1. I'll just leave it at 3, 2, and 1. I ran 3 probably for most of the stint and then turned it up to 4. I thought it was pretty good. Gained a little bit of time running the TC3. Fuel, 55 liters. Number 1 brake pad. Anti-roll bar got 2. Brake bias is 52.1. You can go down to 51. Steering all the way down. Springs on the front are 150,000 with a bump stop rate of 400 and a bump stop range of 15. And on the rear, the springs are 135,000 with a bump stop rate of 350 and a bump stop range of 30. Anti-roll bar is 4 and the preload is 90. So again, that same springs that I ran in the race, but I changed the rates and the ranges. So again, I think it's much more compliant. Shocks in the front are 4, 2, 12, and 4. And on the rear, they're 2, 1, 6, and 3. All dialed in by Motec. And they come out really good. Aero got 52 in the front, 60 in the rear with a maxed wing at 8 and a 4 and a 4 in the brake ducts. And the front aero variation is a 1.4 to the positive. So, again, here, same as I had in the race. Having plenty of clearance. And I turned the wing down one click. It speeds exactly the same, so you don't gain anything in speed down the back straightaway. And here it's all handling and how it, braking and handling are just huge here. Speed is very slow. I mean, it's like Laguna Seca type thing. I mean, your spec speed is like 144 to 146, depending upon the car, or 147, something like that. Like I said, depending upon the car. I was turning 146 down the back straightaway here, even with the max wing, so it was plenty decent. Again, I'm really happy with the setup. I think it's a really good overall setup that you could do everything with. Even in the rain, I probably wouldn't do much of anything other than change the electronics and just roll with it. Maybe run a little bit more negative toe. I probably would max it out in the rain, just to get a little bit more heat in the tires if it was a full rain event. But again, really great setup that you can do a lot with, and I hope you enjoy it. Again, the setup link will be in the description, and of course my Discord link will be in the description also. And of course all my setups are free for you to use and try, and hopefully they'll work good for you. I appreciate a like and subscribe if you could. It would be really great to help the channel out. And also sharing and all that is awesome. Really appreciate that also. And again, thanks to Mark and Larry for their support. And again, I hope you all, enjoyed the race. And again, next week it's at Imola. And I think it's going to be a rain event. So again, great chance of it anyway. So that'll be a little different. But I'm really confident with the BMW that I think it will do well. So again, hopefully we'll have a good race, and I hope you come and join me again next week and also during the week. So again, I appreciate it, and y'all have a good one, and take care.